Namaskar everyone. Today we are going to enact the play Mother's Day by J.B. Priestley, which deals with the theme how a mother is milled in her everyday household work and is bullied by her own family members. Now Mrs. Pearson is a gentle and submissive lady, and her husband George, daughter Doris and son Cyril take her for granted. We'll see how this mother changes the situation to her favour. Now let me take you to Mrs. Pearson's house, where she's talking to her friend, Mrs. Fitzgerald.
Make up your mind, Mrs. Pearson. All depends on yourself. Put your foot down for once and for all. Be the boss of your family.
Thanks, Mrs. Fitzgerald. I'm much obliged. It's wonderful to have a real fortune teller living next door. But it's easier said than done. I'm so fond of them, even if they're so thoughtless and selfish.
You are spoiling your son and daughter along with your husband. They should not be giving you orders and treating you like dirt.
Yes, but I keep dropping hints.
Hints? It's more your family needs. Husbands, sons and daughters need to take notice of their wives and mothers.
I know, but I don't know what to do and how to begin.
Then let me do it for you, Mrs. Pearson.
Oh, no, no.
Come on, give me your hands. That's your only hope. Ashratalam, Ashratadam, Ashratalam Dam.
Mrs. Fitzgerald chants some mantras and the personalities interchange. Now Mrs. Pearson becomes Mrs. Fitzgerald and Mrs. Fitzgerald becomes Mrs. Pearson. Now Mrs. Fitzgerald is a nervous and fluttering lady and Mrs. Pearson, she's the bold one.
Oh, it's happened.
Yes, it's happened. Very neat.
But George and children can't see me like this.
Stop worrying. It's easier to change.
What do I do now?
Go to my house and rest before anyone comes.
After Mrs. Fitzgerald takes her leave, Doris, Mrs. Pearson's daughter, comes bursting in.
Mom, you have to iron my yellow silk.
I must wear it tonight.
What are you doing?
What do you think I'm doing? Whitewashing the ceiling?
But you are playing cards.
Yes, dear. No law against it. Is there any?
I thought you never played cards.
Then you were wrong.
Anyway, will we have tea in the kitchen?
Have it wherever you want.
You mean tea isn't ready?
Yours isn't. I've had what I want.
What's the matter with you?
Don't be silly.
I am not being silly. I have been working hard all day and you cannot even get my tea ready. And didn't you hear what I said about my yellow silk? I want it ironed.
Want it ironed? What do you think? It's going to iron itself.
No, you are going to iron it for me.
This time, I won't. I work twice as many hours as you and get no wages for it. Where are you going, by the way?
Out with Charlie Spence.
Why?
Why shouldn't I go out with Charlie Spence?
Can't you find anybody better? He's buck teeth and half-witted.
No, he isn't.
After Doris leaves crying, Cyril enters the room.
Hey, Mom. Is the tea ready?
No, it isn't.
Why?
I couldn't bother.
What's the idea?
Just to change.
Well, change your mind. I don't have much time.
I have plenty of time.
But I don't have. I've got a busy night tonight. Have you put my things together? You said you will see if there's any mending required.
Well, now I have decided. I don't like mending.
That's a nice way to talk. What if we also start talking to you like that?
You already talk like that. You don't do anything, just want me to do everything.
What's going on?
He leaves the room angrily and meets Doris upstairs.
Has she been like that with you too?
Yes.
I thought I had done something wrong. She was playing cards when I came in. I couldn't believe my eyes.
I asked if she was feeling a little off color, but she said she wasn't.
Well, she's suddenly all different. Do you think she has hit her head or something? If she's going to be like this when Dad comes?
I bet.
While tattling about their mother, the siblings didn't realize that Mrs. Pearson was listening.
Will you two keep talking like this? Why don't you both try once at your age?
What's making you talk like this? Why won't you make a tea ready?
Why can't you help yourself?
I've been working 8 hours a day.
8 hours? I have already done my 8 hours.
That's different.
No, it isn't. 40 hours a week from now on and 2 days off at the weekends.
Mom, you mean you're not going to do anything on Saturdays and Sundays?
That's exactly what I'm going to do. I'm also going to enjoy my weekend.
But where will you go?
That's none of your business.
Did you fall off the bed or hit yourself with something?
I'll surely hit you with something if you don't stop asking me silly questions.
Oh, this is awful.
Stop blabbering. You're not a baby. You're old enough to take care of yourself.
George Pearson enters and Doris leaves without a word.
Did he say something to her?
Ask her.
By the way, I forgot to tell you. In the morning, I wouldn't want any tea ready. Going to club for a snooker match.
That's alright, there's no tea ready.
That's all very well, but what if I wanted to have some?
Goodness, listen to this man. Annoyed because I don't get tea ready for him that he doesn't even want. Ever tried that at the club?
Tried at the club?
They will laugh at you more than they do now, Mr. Pompey Pearson.
Pompey Pearson? What do you mean?
That's what they call you there, leaving your wife at home night after night instead of going out with her.
What has happened to her?
Look who's there.
It's that old silly bat from the next door.
Don't you dare call her that. She's a very nice lady.
No, she isn't.
Of course she is. You be quiet.
Hello, what's happening?
Just putting them in the right places.
Mrs. Fitzgerald?
Yes, George.
George? Why are you calling me George?
What's wrong in that? Who are you? The Duke of Edinburgh?
George also leaves the room, bewildered by his wife's behavior.
It's going out of hands now. Let's return back to our bodies. I can't stand it anymore.
Don't worry, it's just fine. Didn't you see the change in their behavior? But if you want so.
They hold hands and Mrs. Pearson chants some mantras and then their bodies jerk.
I enjoyed.
I didn't.
It's okay. Don't ask for any sorry to them now. Be firm with them.
Hey, you all can come now. Would you like some tea, Mrs. Fitzgerald? Doris, will you make some tea?
Whatever you say, Mom.
No, I'm leaving. You enjoy your moment with your family.
George, should we play some rummy?
That's fine with me.
Children, get their supper ready while I'll talk to your father.
That's okay, Mother.
Well, this was how Mrs. Fitzgerald helps her neighbor, Mrs. Pearson, to chastise and reform George, Cyril, and Doris. She also teaches her that over-pampering and catering to your loved ones can do a little bit harm. Well, a little bit of independence never hurts anybody, does it? A tough love is required for one's growth. And with that, let me take my leave. Until next time.